Before I even get into what I'm about to get into, let me say that this is not to put a blemish or diminish or abolish anything that Puff Daddy has established here, you know, in this world. You know what I mean? He's that you can just go anywhere out the country and just say Puffy or Puff Daddy. Everybody know he's a phenomenal businessman, and he has been a great example of basically what a father is supposed to be, what a black businessman, just a businessman, period. So this is not to discredit. And the person that he was at 24 years old, that's not the individual that he's is in his 40s. So this is not to discredit Puffy. And I love, you know, man, I got a lot of love for Misa as well. You know, very gorgeous, always, you know what I mean, had it together when it came to fashion. You know what I mean? Cold, man, cold with it. But I have to give clarity, and I have to give history, because there's people that's trying to rewrite history, and there's people that's trying to attack one individual when I know for, in fact, if these individuals were sincerely and earnestly, you know, and genuinely against pedophilia and against pedophiles, then it wouldn't be a one individual thing. It would be a whole population thing. Because whenever you're judging righteous judgment, there's no favoritism in righteous judgment. There's no compromisation in righteous judgment. So when you're judging righteously, you're not just looking at a individual, but the population as well as that individual that's in that mess. And everybody right now, as I've said in times past, everybody right now is attacking R. Kelly. And that's fine and dandy. I'm not making any justifiable statements for R. Kelly. You know, as we have seen in times past, R. Kelly got urine proceeding, you know what I mean, from his member to the body of a minor. R. Kelly is marrying a 15-year-old. He got, you know, a bunch of, I mean, he used to go cross country and sit up there and go to the mall and campaign, you know what I mean, for teenagers. He used to be outside of High Park, Kenwood High School, you know what I mean, parked outside with the music playing, trying to impress teenagers. So this is not to justify R. Kelly or be on the side of R. Kelly. But if you're going to convince me and others with a mind and discernment that you're actually genuine and authentic about, you know, your desire to, you know, mute, you know, anybody like R. Kelly or R. Kelly, then let's just not just attack R. Kelly. You know, let's basically put the spotlight on individuals as well who've been involved in the same thing. Because like I said, when I was getting ridiculed and criticized, I didn't call nobody else's name out. I just took the ridicule. I just took the verbal crucifixion. And now I'm saying the same verbal crucifixion, even worse, you know, go down on R. Kelly because he's more famous. But, you know, I know that this is basically just off the influence of social engineering because people don't have their own mind. But as you know, those that know the history, you know that pretty much, you know, Misa, you know what I mean, was 16 years old when Puffy impregnated her. Okay, she was actually younger than 16 when they were together, you know, but that's another story. But that young fly little gentleman, Justin, that Puffy has, you know, that I believe is like the age of 25, if I'm not mistaken. But when Puffy got her impregnated, she was 16 and Puffy was 24. Okay. Was Puffy criticized or minimized, you know, for him basically getting in between the thighs of a 16-year-old and having a baby with a baby at that particular time, or even now? Does that ever get brought up? No. But one thing I will tell you, if Puffy ever get out of bounds or ever get out of pocket with the powers that be, they're going to shine a light on all the abominations and things that he did that was contrary to right in times past. They're going to shine a light on that. In the same way people are coming on one accord to destroy the legacy and the character, you know, of one individual, they can do it to you, him, and him, and him, and him. And because blacks as a whole don't have their own mind, they will, oh man, Puffy, you just so, oh Puffy, you're so brilliant, oh you're so intelligent, oh your mind is infinite, man, Oh, wow. You know, and then when the powers that be, you know, fall out with Puffy, those same individuals. How could you, Puffy? Puffy, you need to go to hell. Puffy, you ain't right, man. I always knew something wasn't right about you. Black people are phony, as a whole, phony. You know what I mean? The things that you're seeing on social media, this fake social media energy and love for children and things like that. No, this is false. This is an Oscar award performance. You know what I mean? People are just not bold enough to come out and say certain things. You know what I mean? Because, of course, just like my last video when I spoke about Jay-Z and Foxy Brown, you know, because certain individuals, Jay-Z is a god to them. You know what I mean? They ran faster to defend Jay-Z faster than they would defend their mama, faster than they would defend their sister, faster than they would defend a black woman that's being beat up by a white man in a black neighborhood. They ran faster to Jay-Z. Why? Because he's the black male Oprah. Because he's a god to them, he's an idol to them. They commit idolatry with him. So even when you point out things that not even just Foxy Brown, but looking at basically the time that he met Destiny's met Beyonce on the No 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 Destiny Child video set, and we know she wasn't 18 then. In 2007, during the interview, when he was asked, "When did you meet Beyonce?" He didn't want to give a direct answer because that would pretty much make people think like, "What?" You know what I mean? And even with, the time when they started dating and how old he was, that particular, I could have went there. But I know that these particular guys is gonna be boo-hooing and crying and pulling off their panties in the comments section, you know, crying. So to keep all of the tears, and because if I sit up there and allow all you little niggas to cry in the comments section and keep crying, what the baby's gonna do? You didn't sit up there and took their job. But you know, I'm just putting paint where it ain't, man, and saying what most can't and afraid to say. You know what I mean? And giving clarity and giving real history, because a lot of you don't know history, so a lot of older people are able to take advantage of the fact that you wasn't there, or you're just not, you know, knowledgeable or had a desire to seek. But and like I said, this is not to sit up there and minimize the character of Misa, because she's doing great in fashion, and you know, a lot of you ridicule Misa because let me also say this and give you history, because there'd be a lot of individuals, yeah, Misa was the one that was messing with Suge while she was with Puffy. That's incorrect. You know, did she mess with Suge? Yes, she was messing with Suge during the same time that Pac was messing with Faith. But during the time that she had her little thing with Suge, she wasn't in no relationship with Puffy. And there were some things that I could have said, but I can't say it because you know why I could say it, but Kim is gone and there's no need to say that. You know, but Misa, out of basically the mothers that Puffy, baby mothers that he has, you know what I mean? Out of all of them, in my eyes, of course, Misa would be the most honorable one. You know what I mean? I love Kim. She was a woman, you know what I mean, of a man. She was just beautiful inside and out. But, you know, she had her ways, and everybody had their little ways too. But Misa always was hood. Misa was real. And, you know, she had a personality that made you gravitate to her. And obviously so, Puffy gravitated to her at the age of 24, and she was 16. At the time, and not only that, he had a baby with her. So now, are you going to mute, you know, bad boy music? Are you going to mute the music of Biggie? Are you going to mute the music of Craig Mack? Are you going to say that I'm going to stop listening to anything that came from Bad Boy Records simply because it was founded by a pedophile? Are you going to say that Biggie is not who he is, or the music is not what it is, you know what I mean? Because Puffy was behind it, he was producing, and I can't listen to no music, you know what I mean, that a pedophile produced. I can't listen to no music, you know what I mean, that came from a label that a pedophile started. No, you're not. You're gonna sit up there and keep listening to Bad Boy. So if you're willing to mute the music of R. Kelly, then please be willing to mute all the other artists and the individuals as businessmen, you know what I mean, that even started labels and everything as well. I told you, man, I'm giving the history. I want you to sit up there and look at this thing. If you're willing to stop listening to the art of an artist, because of the personal life of an artist that you don't agree with, then all I'm saying is not justifying nobody, but be willing to sit up there and stop listening to the art and paying attention to the art of the individuals as well that's been involved in the same thing. Don't have no favoritism. That's all I'm saying to you. If you're going to sit up there and really sit up there, you know what I mean, and say that you hate pedophiles, you hate pedophilia, and we got to stop supporting R. Kelly, then we need to stop supporting the others that was involved in these type of things as well, not just one. When you're sincere, when you are authentic, when you're genuine, you don't just point the finger at one. You point the finger at the whole population that's involved in this abomination that you're disgusted with. You don't pick and choose. Ain't no favoritism. Ain't no compromisation in righteous judgment. I'm just teaching you how to judge righteously, baby. I'm just influencing you and encouraging you to have your own mind. That's all I'm saying. And before you make another status and video about R. Kelly, I need for you to take the time out to do research on the music industry. Because as you do research on the music industry in the genre of R&B and the genre of hip hop, you know what I mean? You will see that a lot of the pioneers was pretty much on the same level as R. Kelly, or even a little bit more abominable. Because hip hop is one of hip hop's pioneers. You know what I mean? R. Kelly is not even competing with. R. Kelly is not even on the same wavelength as African Bambaataa. But you still going to sit up there and listen to hip-hop. You're not going to say, I'm going to stop listening to hip-hop and I can't listen to hip-hop no more because one of the pioneers of hip-hop is a pedophile and a father of pedophiles. Because he touched individuals that went out into the streets touching. Facts. Okay? Another thing. And not saying that that brother is telling the truth or basically he's giving false information, but just to give confirmation of the information that I'm conveying and saying within this video, just to let you know that individuals pick and choose who they want to criticize and minimize. There's one individual, as you know, on YouTube. I ain't got to say his particular name, but you guys know basically who I was going back and forth. Matter of fact, I even said Hassan. Now, when I was roasting Hassan, or when others are roasting Hassan, notice that individuals is all in the comment section. Oh my God, nigga, you was 15. Nigga, you knew better, man. Y'all don't want to hear when I was 15. I knew better when I was 15. When I was 15, you ain't know nowhere in the world at 15 years old. And these same individuals that said at 15 that they knew better, that they wouldn't allow no man to do what Hassan allowed African Bambaataa to do, is the same ones that's basically tearing down and destroying R. Kelly and just making him the predator, but making these 15 and 16 and 14 year old girls victims. Did they not know any better? Do you have compromisation within your judgment? Do you have favoritism in your judgment? Is it a double standard within your judgment? I'm raising the consciousness on today. I'm showing you the hypocrisy within the community today, because after all of these videos, after all of the beautiful long speeches that people going to type in the comment section, none of them motherfuckers is going to go outside and start a movement. And like I said, you can convey your belief, but your belief don't mean shit until you take your ass outside and enforce your belief. So if you truly are against others touching children, then why not create a movement that could hinder individuals from touching children? Because the white man is not going to give you justice, basically, for a man touching a black little girl. No, he's not. He could care less. You think R. Kelly will still have his liberty in society if he had gotten to a continuity of basically sitting over there touching little white girls? No, he would not. But due to the fact that it's black girls, he still has his liberty in society and has an opportunity to still do whatever the fuck he wants when he wants. You know what I mean? So if we truly possess the love that we profess to have for young black females, for young little black girls, and if a nation can't rise above its woman, and if the black woman is the first teacher of the child, if we truly love ourselves as a whole, if we truly love, you know what I mean, our nation, then we would take the time out, you know what I mean, to protect our children from these abominations that can transpire, you know, to them as well. The love that we profess to have in these YouTube videos and the love that we profess to have for that religious shit when you sitting over there conveying things over the pulpit, if you genuinely felt like that, then you would protect, you know what I mean, the youth, because the truth is the youth is the future. So if you want us to get better as a people, then you have to create a movement that will hinder anything. Receiving super chats, comments and likes and shares, you know, that's cute. But the real movement is outside. And until you got a movement outside, the truth is the black community is going to continue to subside. The black community has already shown you that music is more important than, you know what I mean, our future, which are the children. You know what I mean? And not to say that you should stop or you should keep on. I'm not influencing neither. That's up to you. My opinion has no dominion over that. I'm just here to put things in proper perspective and tell you that if you're going to stop listening to one individual, let me show you other individuals who has done some of the same things or worse. So if you stop listening to his music, you should stop listening to his music. Hell, you should stop listening to the whole fucking genre of this particular music simply because 9 out of 10, it was started by a goddamn pedophile. So if you're going to mute R. Kelly, then be willing to mute anything that Puffy had something to do with. Be willing to mute anything African Bambaataa had something to do with. And last time I checked, he had something to do with hip hop. So I just want to put paint where it ain't and say what most can't. I just want to give clarity and show charity and give you a little history, because I know right now individuals are able to rewrite history and basically sit up there and paint a picture, you know what I mean, of R. Kelly as this monster, when the truth is, you know what I mean, that monster was produced. He's the fruit from something. And in order for us to hinder any more fruit that will be worse than R. Kelly, then we need to basically go to the root. We need to stop complaining and bitching about the fruit and go to the root and destroy the root of the problem. And the only way we can do that is start a movement that will hinder all of that, destroy all of that. That means that we got to love ourselves and our children, because it takes a village to raise a child. We have to love these children more than R&B songs. We got to love our children more than rap songs. And for these, we need real parents, not individuals that have the title of a parent, but not willing to do the things that's vital to the title of a parent. Because if you sincerely love your child, then you're not going to sacrifice your child to Baal. Sin, sacrifice my child to Baal. Yes, anytime that you want to be a star or you want some type of fame, if you really sincerely loved your child, you're not going to sit up there. Listen, if I had a daughter and you molested my daughter or touched my daughter, ain't a dime in this world that you can give me in a settlement for me to say, oh, you gave me $10 million, it's all right. You gave me $50 million, it's all right. It's not all right. If you raped my daughter or did anything to my, especially my young teenage or underage daughter, I'm not going to wait for the white man to give me motherfucking justice. I'm going to come for your ass. Why? Because I sincerely possess the love that I profess to have for my daughter. So, you know, man, I'm just going to make sure I got enough money to do my time, you know what I mean, when they get me or whenever they get me, you know, so I can sit up there and have on my books. Certain things is willing to go to, I'm willing to go to jail for. Certain things that I'm willing to go to prison for. And if I have this type of mentality and carnality, then how is it that you guys that profess to be in spirituality or profess to have a positive mentality, how come you don't have that same energy pertaining to children? You guys are hypocrites, and you pick and choose who you want to criticize and minimize. But I'm not here to really just do too much judgment, but I'm here to make you realize that you don't even have your own mind. You're being influenced. You're being encouraged, you know what I mean, by the powers that be to destroy another legacy of the black man. But if you're going to destroy the life and the lifestyle, the legacy of one black man, you got to be willing to do that, you know what I mean, with the white man, the Jewish man, the Russian man, and so on, that's been involved in the same thing. There is no favoritism and compromisation and righteous judgment. I hope you guys share this. I hope you hit the like button. I hope you get in the comment section and give me your thoughts. I just have to give you mine. And I also have to show you that your thoughts are really not your thoughts. That's just a result of social engineering. I love you guys. Stay blessed. Hope you live as long as you want. Never want as long as you live. One.